Now Royce, Werner, back to Marco Royce, back to Timo Werner. This should be a goal. Spain getting absolutely dismantled here. Within the first 12 minutes, we've made it 2-0. Here's Müller. Could try and curl this one in. Goes for the goal, and oh my goodness, Thomas Müller has just scored one of the best goals I've scored so far in FIFA 20. So welcome back to episode number 2 of the Germany Career Mode series, where we'll be continuing our UEFA Euro 2020 journey. Last episode, we completed all our 3 group stage games and we somehow managed to top our group over Poland, Spain and Greece. And well, surprisingly, Spain haven't made it to the quarterfinals of the Euros. In today's episode, we're going to be wrapping up the tournament. We're going to have the quarterfinals, potentially the semifinals, and potentially the finals as well. So I'm really hoping we can win the Euros with Germany in today's video. So if you guys have enjoyed this mini-series with Germany, I would really appreciate a like on the video. Let's try and smash out 2,000 likes. And if you are new around here, make sure to subscribe for more FIFA 20 Career Mode content. Also, I've got a quick update for you guys. The Barcelona Career Mode will be returning this Thursday for Season 2, and I genuinely can't wait for it. So it is now time to find out who we'll be facing in the quarterfinals of the Euros. We finished first in our group, so that should give us an easier draw. So let's see who we'll be facing in the quarterfinals. And it is Denmark. Probably a tricky team to face because they do have the likes of Christian Eriksen and all. So it's not going to be an easy game. But looking at the other games, we've got Netherlands and England. England managed to beat them 1-0. Poland knocked out Portugal. And Belgium knocked out Italy. So it's now time to find out which team will be going through between Germany and Denmark. So far in this tournament, Eden Hazard has been something else, scoring 4 goals in 4 games. Bergwijn and De Jong for Netherlands have been balling out. A lot of you guys thought that this was Luke De Jong from Netherlands who's been scoring in the Euros, but it's actually Frankie De Jong. I went ahead and checked that. So, well, our Barcelona boy is performing for his country as well. Timo Werner, one of our top scorers in there as well. I'm hoping he can win the Golden Boot Award. That would be really nice to see. Assist-wise, I mean, look at that. Timo Werner has been balling out for us with 3 assists, which is great to see. And of course, with a couple of goals and 3 assists, there was no one else who was going to win the Player of the Episode award. You guys voted for Timo Werner, who was brilliant in that last episode. Scored so many important goals for us against Spain and even, I think, in that second game that we played in the group stages against Greece. So he's been brilliant. And of course, you guys voted for him as your Player of the Episode. So here we go. It is time for the knockout rounds. Germany versus Denmark, the quarterfinals, and this is how I'm lining the team up. I'm sticking with the 4-4-1-1 formation. It was brilliant against Spain, where we, of course, beat them 4-0, so it doesn't really make changing formations, but you guys have suggested me to put Toni Kroos in the lineup because of the fact that he gives us a bit more balance along with Leon Goretzka, so that is why Kai Havertz misses out. So Werner up front, Royce in that cam role, Sane and Gnabry on either side. We've got Jonathan Tah starting ahead of course, Mats Hummels, because, well, I need pace, man. Pace is so important in FIFA 20. Kimmich and Schultz on either side. Ter Stegen in goal. I'm hoping this team can get the job done in the quarterfinals of the Euros. So this is the Denmark team we're facing, and honestly, they've got a great team. Paulsen is pretty good. Christian Eriksen, of course, is world-class. Delaney, Vaz, Pione Sisto has been performing really well in this tournament. At the back, they've got Christensen. They've got Kasper Schmeichel as well. Dormisi is a good left-back. This is actually a good Denmark side, and we've got to be careful. Otherwise, we could end up getting knocked out. We've got Toni Kroos looking to start a counter-attack. That is a beautiful pass in it to Serge Gnabry, who we know has got the pace. Gnabry in a 1v1 situation. The player tries to trip him there. And how is the ref not given a penalty or something for that? Maybe because Gnabry didn't go down. Oh no, Pione Sisto has broken through. We know how quick he is. The cutback was not good enough. And somehow we get away with that. But Kimmich, man, he is getting pace abused down this left flank. Here we go, Serge Gnabry on the ball now. Still Gnabry, cuts this one back, Sane controls it, can't really get the shot off. We find Toni Kroos though, we know he's got a good long shot in him, shoots, but it takes a big deflection. Gnabry inside to Leon Goretzka. Now Werner finds Marco Royce, this should be a goal and it's off the post. Marco Royce, our captain, misses a golden chance there to give us the lead against, of course, Denmark. It was great build-up play. Royce from that position should be scoring, man, especially with that 4-star week that he's got. That's a big chance gone. Leon Goretzka in behind now. The Denmark defense. Can Werner get there first? He can. Timo Werner, can he score this? No. Kasper Schmeichel with an incredible reflex save there. Werner again using his pace to get in behind that Denmark defense. We've got to be, you know, using that more often. Daniel Vaz in behind to Yusuf Poulsen. Ter Stegen is coming forward. What, he stripped his own player? That was absolutely hilarious. Jonathan Tardo gets it away. That was chaos there. Marco Reus in behind now to Serge Gnabry. Gnabry cut back. Timo Werner goes for goal and he scores. Let's go, guys. In the first half, we've managed to get ourselves the lead. For some reason, the teammates just don't want to celebrate. I have no idea what FIFA 20 even is at this point, man. Some of the stuff is just so broken. Teammates just don't want to celebrate a goal in the knockout rounds of the Euros. Anyways, Gnabry with the cutback. Timo Werner with a ridiculously good finish there. He is so good in this game, guys. I thought he wouldn't be this good because of the fact that he doesn't have like a 4-star skill move and all that. But he's still as lethal as it gets. A great finish from the German. Denmark pushing forward with Daniel Vaz. Now it's Eriksen finds Yusuf Poulsen who shoots. And that was actually a proper good opportunity there for Denmark. Probably their first attack of the game and they almost scored from it. Thankfully, we've got Ter Stegen in goal. Oh, beautiful pass out wide to Leroy Sané who controls it with perfection as well. And now our chance to try and make it, of course, 2-0. Marco Reus goes for goal and he ain't missing his second of the game as Marco Reus gives us a 2-0 advantage in the 64th minute. Now, this is a comfortable lead to have. A really good goal. Toni Kroos in that build-up play was brilliant as well, finding Sané, then Werner, then Reus, and then bang, another goal for, of course, Germany. Reus getting his first goal of the game. I thought he got his second. It was Werner who scored our first goal, though. So 2-0 up against Denmark. Let's get our spot in the semi-final secured. Toni Kroos, and now on the counter-attack, we've got another opportunity. Marco Reus pushing forward with pace. Cuts this one for Werner. Should be an easy goal. It is an easy goal. And in added time, we've made it 3-0 against Denmark. Werner getting his second off the game. Reus with the assist for Toni Kroos once again in the build-up play was superb. I guess there's maybe more to him than I expected. So he might be starting in further games as well because Kroos was superb in this one. Regardless, 3-0 up and job done. Full time against Denmark and we are through to the semi-finals of the Euros. 3-0 against them, really convincing performance and I now can't wait to find out who we'll be facing in the semi-finals. We've made it to the semi-finals of the Euros and it's going to be Belgium that we'll be facing. This is going to be one hell of a game. We know Belgium have got some world-class players. They've got an in-form Eden Hazard at the moment and that is going to be dangerous. We know how good Hazard is, but not just that. They've got a whole host of incredible players. Axel Witsel. They've got, of course, Lukaku as well at the back. They've got Vertonghen, Alto Wiedeld. It's a great team that we'll be facing. And if we get to the finals, it's going to be England that we'll be facing. England, Germany in the finals of the Euros. That could be a lot of fun. But first, we need to get past Belgium. There's something about Toni Kroos, man, in this game. I know he's not the quickest of players. In fact, he's abysmal in terms of pace. 44 pace is just embarrassing. But in that last game, he didn't misplace a single pass. His passing was pinpoint and that helped us create quite a few goals. And that's why I've decided to start him from now on in this tournament. And I guess this is going to be my first 11. And of course, we've got a very good bench to use when it needs be. But yeah, this is the first 11 that I'm hoping will get us the Euro trophy. Hazard and Werner are competing for that top goal scorer award. Both have 4 goals each in 4 games. Sisto is now out of the competition, so is Lewandowski. So it is a tough battle there between, of course, Hazard and Werner. So let's try and knock Belgium out. So as I said, this is how my team is looking like for the rest of this tournament. I'm sticking with this lineup. Werner starting up front. Reus in that centre forward role. Sané and Gnabry on either side. Kroos starting with Goretzka. Charles, Sula, Tah, Kimmich at the back. Ter Stegen in goal. What even is this formation, man? Belgium are playing all-out attack against us in the semi-finals. They've got Kompany, Alto Wiedeld and Vertonghen at the back. De Bruyne captaining that team in a midfield with Witsel. I mean, Carrasco, Mertens on either side. Look at how attacking this side is. Hazard, Thorgan Hazard, the two brothers up front with Lukaku playing as the number 9. I guess this is going to be interesting because we're going to have to defend a lot, I suppose, in this one. Hazard looking to create space against us. Hazard puts this one back in. We do get it away, but that's what I'm talking about, guys. Witsel now shoots and almost scores there. Eden Hazard is the danger man. He's been in great form so far in this tournament, and he's the player we've got to really defend well against. Here goes Timo Werner on the attack, pushing forward with pace. This is what happens when you play an all-out attack formation. You get countered as Werner almost scores there. Courtois making a big save for, of course, his side. Oh no, Hazard's broken through here. Hazard, it's still Hazard now, 1v1 against Ter Stegen, and he can't keep that one out. Eden Hazard has scored against Germany early on in this one. I told you guys, man, Hazard is just such a difficult player to defend against, and he's now scored a really good goal with that left foot of his. He got past our defense so easily. Süle couldn't keep up with him, and it was a great finish as well. We've got a tough job ahead of us. Gets past his man, still Royce. Looks to bring it inside, finds Leon Goretzka, who's got a good shot on him, goes for goal. Courtois with an unbelievable save there. With that left foot of his, I thought Goretzka was going to score that, an absolute screamer, but the keeper saved it. Goretzka in behind to Leroy Sané. This is brilliant. Cut back inside to Werner. This is brilliant football there from Germany, and we are right back in it. 1-1 against Belgium. That pass there from, I think, Goretzka, was it, to Leroy Sané was just world-class. Have a look at this for a pass. Oh, just brilliant. And then Sané's cross into Werner, world-class as well. And, well, we've equalized. Timo Werner just can't stop scoring. It's 1-1 and game on. Here's Toni Kroos. Royce back to Kroos. This is brilliant from Toni Kroos. He goes for goal and he's actually scored. Toni Kroos has made it 2-1 against Belgium just before the halftime whistle. And to think I was actually considering benching him in this tournament. The guy is so good in this game. I know he's got 44 pace, but for some reason, man, he just feels great on the ball. His dribbling is perfect. His shooting is incredible. And of course, he puts us in to a 2-1 advantage just before the halftime whistle. Let's go, guys. A big goal there from Toni Kroos. Halftime against Belgium, and we have turned things around. When Hazard scored that first goal, I thought, ah, here we go again. It's going to get tough. But then we responded brilliantly with Werner and Kroos scoring. Let's now get the job done in the second half. Marco Reus gets past his man. Still Reus. Reus shoots, but he drags it short wide. 3-1. And that would have been done for this game, and we would have basically booked our spot in the finals. But Reus couldn't, you know, keep this one on target. Kroos in behind to Gnabry. That's what I'm talking about, guys. Toni Kroos is just insane in this game. And that should be 3-1. Kroos with another assist as Germany make it 3-1 against Belgium. Gnabry does his classic celebration. And guess what, guys? His teammates, somewhat, are finally celebrating with him. 3-1. And I can't see Belgium getting back in this one. Gnabry with a really good goal with that weaker left foot of his. Oh, Belgium have given it away to Marco Reus as he's broken through. The Belgium defense have just completely switched off. Reus shoots. Reus scores. This time he does keep a shot on target as we make it 4-1 against Belgium. I mean, I know they've got a very aggressive formation, but this kind of defending is just appalling. Regardless, we've taken complete advantage of this and we've made it 4-1. And we are so close now to making that final. Thorgan Hazard on the ball now, gets past the Germany defender, cuts this one back to Yannick Carrasco, and Belgium do have another goal back. That's frustrating. Full time, and we've knocked out Belgium from the Euros. We are through to the finals of this competition, and we did it in style. What a performance from us, beating them 4-2. Toni Kroos was just brilliant in this game, and apart from that, of course, Werner on the score sheet as well. Great to see us finally performing at such a high level in this tournament, and I'm hoping we can keep this up as we'll be facing England in the final. We can't let football come home, can we? So we are in the finals of the UEFA Euro 2020, England going up against Germany, and it's going to be a cracking game of football because both sides have got world-class players, with England having the likes of Kane, Jadon Sancho, Dele Alli and all that. It's going to be a tough game of football, but so do we. We have got some great players as well, and I can't wait for this final. So it does look like Timo Werner is going to end up as the top goal scorer of the tournament. He scored 5 so far. Hazard scored 5, but remember, we just knocked Belgium out. And there's no England player in the top 10. There's only Nathan Redmond with 1 goal. Who's been scoring goals for England, man? Pretty weird to see that. But anyways, it's good to see Werner at the very top. He's also the top assister. Marco Reus just 1 assist behind him. Crazy to see that. UEFA Euro 2020 final. Let's wrap this series off with the trophy. This is how the team is lining up. Timo is playing up front. Reus in behind him. Kroos has been brilliant, so he's starting this one as well. Gnabry on the right, Sané on the left. We've got Süle, Tah all starting. I'm not changing a thing because there's no need to change anything when you've just beaten Belgium 4-2. So we're keeping things as is. Let's go out there and get the trophy home. This is the England team that we're facing and they don't have Jadon Sancho. Wow, that's incredible. He's probably on the bench. Ryan Sessegnon starting down at that left flank. Raheem Sterling on the right. Kane up front. Ali Wings Henderson in that midfield. Kyle Walker, Maguire, Stones, Luke Shaw at the back. Pickford and goal. That is a strong England side, but it could have been a lot better with Sancho on the pitch. But for some reason, he isn't. Inside to Marco Reus, who turns. Reus shoots and forces a save, but on the rebound. What? How have we not scored that on the rebound? That was such an easy chance for Gnabry. I think an England defender got a foot to it or something, because how's he missed that from there? Oh no, England have a chance here. It's Dele Alli who's broken through our defence. Oh, the cutback was stopped by Toni Kroos there. Brilliant defending from the German. Finds Toni Kroos. Oh, gets past one. Kroos goes for goal, but that's straight towards Jordan Pickford. England have actually defended really well in this game. We haven't really received any clear-cut chances. It's a free kick for England, but it's from 33 yards. No way Kane is scoring this. He's going to try and go for goal, I guess. That is just awful, man. Here goes Serge Gnabry with pace. This could be our chance before the halftime whistle. Cross comes in. Leroy Sané with the header. No, he couldn't keep this one under. The cross and run from Gnabry was perfect, but... Sané, come on, man. Halftime against England, and so far it's been a stalemate. 0-0. I think both teams have had chances, but you know, we should be 1-0 up with that late chance for Sané, the header. He should have scored that. Regardless, let's get right into this second half and hopefully we can, you know, get a goal so that we can win the tournament. Gnabry, now Goretzka. In behind to Marco Reus. That's a good touch from him. Reus shoots. No, Pickford saved. On the rebound, Goretzka shoots as well. Pickford saves again. An incredible double save there from Jordan Pickford, the Everton man, to deny us from scoring the first goal in this final. Brilliant goalkeeping there from him. Looks like we are seeing Jadon Sancho, who's just been brought on for, of course, Ryan Sessegnon. And here he is on the ball. We've got to be careful defending against him because we know he's got like a 5-star skill move. He's got a 4-star weak foot as well. He is just a lethal player to play against. But now it is actually Raheem Sterling on the other side, creating something for, of course, England. Now it's Sancho. Sancho shoots and he scored. No way. Within minutes of being brought on, Jadon Sancho has given England the lead. Football might just be coming home. 60th minute of this one, and we've conceded. Toni Kroos couldn't clear the ball away properly, and that cost us there, as Sancho has scored. No! Goretzka. Now it's Gnabry. Brilliant touch from Gnabry. Goes for goal. Pickford saves again. Are you kidding me, man? Need to make an attacking change, and that's why Kai Havertz is coming on for Toni Kroos, and I'm hoping this works, man. 15 minutes to get at least one goal back. Oh, Jadon Sancho again with an opportunity. Still, Sancho tries to go for that near post. Ter Stegen denies him. Sancho has just completely changed this game. Leon Goretzka releases Marco Reus. Here goes Reus on the attack. One of our last chances of the game. Marco Reus 1v1. Can't shoot because Maguire denies him. And it's done. We've actually lost the Euros to England of all teams. They've got Jesse Lingard and we lost to them. Are you kidding me, man? We had the chances to win this tournament. We couldn't take them. England brought on Sancho, who had a moment of magic. And well, we've lost the UEFA Euro 2020. Oh, man. This is just so frustrating. After having such a good time at Barcelona, I thought we could really bring Germany back to the top of European football. But England have outdone us. They've won the tournament and they're going to lift the trophy. Disappointing, man. What a year for Henderson. He just captained Liverpool to a Champions League trophy, and now in this series he's captained them to a Euro Cup win as well. Frustrating to say the least. And there you go, England win at the European Championship. We end off this series on a pretty terrible note. Well, at least Timo Werner ends up as the top goal scorer along with Eden Hazard, so at least there's something to celebrate. He also finishes the tournament being the top assister. So guys, that is that for this Germany career mode series. Unfortunately, we couldn't win the Euros, but to be fair, we did play some good football. You can't lie. We beat Belgium 4-2. We beat Spain as well. Unfortunately, we couldn't beat England, but our time with Germany now has come to an end as we'll be resigning. Now, the next international job that we will be taking will, of course, be with a different team for the World Cup. So we're now back at Barcelona and we'll be resuming the Barcelona career mode season 2 very soon on the channel. But that is that for today's video. Disappointing, yeah, to, you know, lose the finals, but it is what it is. That is it for the series. Hopefully you guys have enjoyed this mini series, and if you guys have had, make sure to drop a like in the video, subscribe if you are new around here, and I'll see you guys very soon for season 2 with Barcelona.